This is like I got like my pinky, my pinky. Money, baby, we don't baby, it ain't us. Bet it back, I bet I match it like the same style. Chopsticks for beef, I'm shutting PF chains down. I gave you prophecy, my first one, then you lamed out. Luckily, sold, but it wasn't for me. Still the flow raw, peep the way I bubble in these streets. Who can f*** with me?
Nikki, baby.
Go.
And we welcome all of our viewers inside a place that the folks around here like to call the Vault. And that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Tonight, it's the NFC's turn to take center stage as we've got a wild card matchup on tap between the Detroit Lions and the Carolina Panthers. Winner go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC wild card game. This fielded at the two. Solid return. Pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. And he'll go on the ground. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And with a play clock at 3, we'll get a signal and a timeout on the whistle. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 9.
No. Check. Patriot. All right, now. Lucky 56. Ah!
From the gun, Murray. Over the middle here to Brown. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The result, a first down as the quick slant gets him 14. On 1st and 10, Murray steps away to his left. Now he's going to throw deep, back up. Oh, wide open, complete. And he is able to take this way down into Detroit territory. A big play there for the Panthers. 45 yards. So first and goal and an opportunity for our first points in this wild card game. Yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. So first down went in the wrong direction. They're at the 13-yard line. Here's second and goal. operating from the gun. Murray, now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal. Looking to cash in on this opening drive. Here's a third and goal. They'll give it to him right up the gut. No gain on the play. And what to do now on fourth and goal?
Now, this feels like old-school football because this has turned into a good old-fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on fourth down?
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and sneak it here. Try to wedge his way in there. No signal. I don't think he got there. He didn't. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in. And on the opening drive of the ball game, the defense comes up with a goal line stand. Jesse James, and he's able to get this one up to the 8 yard line this time. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. A first carry now. This is Johnson. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
Now a first carry for Lamar Miller. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
After the penalty, it's Miller. And it worked his way across the 30 to the 32. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Second down, Johnson. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
Shy of midfield. A good pickup there, a 22.
Three,
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. A first down carry now for Miller. A beautiful span and room to run. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Lamar Miller, 55 yards. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead. I think that's the dream start right there. The defense stands up on the opening drive, then they go right down the field and score.
It's a positive start for your offense and your defense. And when you're talking about playoff football, what a great way to get things going.
Everything is magnified and amped up a little bit more.
To put it mildly.
This fielded at the two. Now a hit and a loose football. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Throwing on first down. Murray stepping up. He'll try and run. They'll wind up getting nine after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
To throw on second down, Murray. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. First down, Murray. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. Ziggy Ansah, able to drop him for a loss of four.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card. The pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Ezekiel Ansah in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Here we go.
From the gun, Murray. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up two scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing in these.
That he's into the clear. He's at the 40, the 20, 10, touchdown, Detroit. Kerryon Johnson, 70 yards. And the Lions strike quickly here for 6 points. Well, a lot of things have to go right for an option pitch to be successful. Everything lined up there on the long run.
It does, because you have to make the proper read. It doesn't matter what guy you've decided is going to be read on the defensive front. You still have to execute it. If he comes to the quarterback, you saw there, pitch it out to the running back, and off he goes. A lot of teams don't like to run the option because they don't like having their quarterback hit.
Carolina getting set to take the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points. Get that zero off the board. Now he's going the other way. And that'll be incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second
right, now,
and 10.
Lucky 56.
To throw again, Murray. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Murray now. He's going to air one out. And that one incomplete. Had some position, but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Gone! Over!
And the pitch goes to Miller. And some nifty running there. Ultimately, it doesn't get him a whole lot, but it does take him to the 45. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and two coming up. Midfield before going out of bounds.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down in bounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Detroit!
Again to Miller, and he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Under four to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. They'll look to throw. They'll find a man over the middle. It's Galladay. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
On second down, here's Miller. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And he right rifles one incomplete. He was looking to get it to his running back, Lamar Miller. That'll bring up second down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. They'll hand it off now. Johnson. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. To play here in the first half. Back with more NFC playoff action after this. Here's first and goal, and gosh, points here, a chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime.
Over.
They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run for it with Miller, and he'll take this into the end zone. Now hold on here, we do have a flag down, so let's see what this is about. Here's another first and goal, but from a little further back this time following the penalty.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Miller. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. And give him 5 that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal.
Over.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Lamar Miller with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Lions add on to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, 2 already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3 and out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Murray. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line.
Yeah, he's just trying to throw this ball into the hole in the zone, but those windows can open and close quickly, especially in the middle of the field. So if the timing's not right, we'll see interceptions like that one right there.
Over.
10th carry now for Lamar Miller. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
Gone.
They're going to look to throw. Going up top. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down at the 34. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And that stretches this lead even further. It's now 24-0. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. It's what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you've got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And this is going to be incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. Only way to play good defense.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
And the penalty helps, but not a whole lot. It's still third and long. Operating from the gun. Murray, and he fires one that's intercepted. Terrence Brooks with a pick. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. That pick six extending this lead even further. Boy, it's been a while since I've seen a team struggle this badly in the first half.
I think all they want to do is get to the locker room, try and regroup, and come out to start the third quarter. But if things don't improve fast then, I think the backups get a lot of play in the second half.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Final 12 seconds of the half now as they've got it first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. Bust through the tackle. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. So we come upon and just like that, on we head to half number two. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Line of scrimmage, again, the 25, Detroit! Second and 10.
Back to 89, Philly, here we go!
They'll toss it to Miller. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
On third down, Miller. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Going to make that defense stand up and stop them. First down carry here for Johnson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Miller. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. The Lions on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and six. Now a handoff. Johnson. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up fourth down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And here now the punter, Martin, booming this one away. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back to the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. Patrick. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. Over the middle, complete. That's Brown. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25. The second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
On first and 10, Murray. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Here's Murray. And the heat jarred it loose. It's incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. From the gun, Murray. And for the third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Room to run inside the 40. And he gets this one down to the 24. 31 yards there and a first down.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to, but they didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. They keep it with Miller on first down. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a lion that's shaken up. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. To the right and complete to Galladay.
Missed.
This will not go down. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
Detroit!
This is Johnson, able to spin free, and able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Devonta Johnson, and he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. Kerryon Johnson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Lions just continue to pour it on. Extra point good by Prater, and the lead will swell by one more. Here's Prater now set to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. Spins by. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is, just what you said, you've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. A gain of 6 there on first. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. On the handoff, this is Howard. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. And we're back now in Charlotte. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Detroit!
And they'll run it here. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Another carry, same story. Fourth quarter, and he is in red numbers right now with a running game.
Hard to believe because you figure at some point you break off a run. But in this case, what we're seeing is just pure domination by the defense. I think it started with the scouting report. They got into what they were doing offensively, into their mindset, and now they're beating them to the punch on every snap.
And his throw here's incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
The Panthers on third down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 8. Operating from the gun. Murray. And that is in. incomplete.
Well, touch and time here are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
They're already slim. Hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he comes back with one complete. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too. This quarterback now, perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. From the gun, Murray. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 47. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They try the left side with Johnson, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. They go to Johnson again. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
And he'll find Galladay, that's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 23 yards on the play. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Now Miller, he's had a big workload here tonight. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over 150 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
Before he could get out of the backfield. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that'll bring up a 3rd and 11 situation. They'll run with Miller. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the 2-minute warning. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And that will just add 3 more to a lead that's already out of hand. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
Carolina getting set to take the field. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage.
Detroit! Detroit!
Now a play fake here on first down. It'll buy some time right. Incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
So a line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Back to the air on second down.
Murray.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be taken down all the way inside Detroit's 20. A big play there for Carolina. 44 yards. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Throwing on first down. Murray fighting. Lost the football. And the Lions have recovered.
As they say, this game hasn't exactly been one for the books. I mean, we're into the fourth quarter here. And now this happens. Another turnover. Not one that they're going to hold up and say, yeah, this has been a banner day.
Absolutely. Still sitting on zero. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
But that certainly felt like an example of a defense just saying, okay, we've had enough. We've gotten mashed all night long. About time we got a good play in. But flip it over to the offensive side. They've got to be really upset that they allowed a play like that to happen. They were pitching such a great game. They want to keep it going.
And a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down.
Gone!
They'll set up a throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now a 20th carry of the game for Lamar Miller. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
They'll break the huddle. Come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. And the Lions will take the knee here with victory in the cards. So a 3rd and 9 and 6 defensive backs out there in the dime.
Patrolling the passing lanes.
They go down to a knee and that will do it. They are moving on here in the playoffs.